Hi, I'm Lillian, and I'm here today to talk about predicting crop yields and malnutrition prevalence through integrated remote sensing and data assessment. My goal was to create a simple, low-cost method to predict crop yields that can be widely applied. First, I did a proof of concept in Illinois, where there is a lot of high-quality data. For every county in Illinois, I computed monthly averages and anomalies of NDVI, EVI, and NDWI. These vegetation indices are strongly correlated to crop yields, shown here for every county and year in Illinois since 2000. During a drought year, they're very negative NDVI anomalies, meaning that these are good predictors of crop failure. A multivariate regression with all three indices over the course of the growing season produced a correlation of 0.86, showing how this simple method is a good indicator of crop health. Next, I applied this method in Africa by first picking out a box in each country where the farming is most dense. So here you can see Ethiopia during a wet year and a dry year. The difference is most evident in the Rift Valley where the farming is most dense. The blue line is the monthly NDVI average, the peak of which is highly correlated to each country's main crops. Ethiopia has a correlation of 0.98 to corn production. I then predicted 2018 harvests and compared them to actual crop productions once these values were published. Ethiopia had an error of 0.64%. This is an online interactive map of future crop predictions, and surrounding it are example plots of 2018 predicted and actual production values. The histogram shows the errors for all 2018 crop predictions. 20% had less than 2% error, and 40% had less than 5% error. There are many difficulties in crop predictions in Africa, including false reporting due to lack of resources, poor oversight or corruption, multiple growing seasons, and clouds in Central African countries. For more detail on these predictions, see my paper published this month in Remote Sensing. These images show farm fields in Illinois and Ethiopia at the same resolution. In Illinois, the method can be tuned for specific crops and growing seasons because of large farm fields and high data availability. In Africa, it is very difficult to tune the method because of a highly heterogeneous landscape, many climates, crops, and growing seasons across the continent. The challenge in Africa is crop prediction that can be applied for any location, crop, and climate. And my method works successfully because it measures relative plant health on a pixel-level anomaly without the use of a crop mask, so it can be applied to any location, crop, or climate. It is unique because it's simple and versatile. It can be run on a laptop computer and was developed over the course of a couple months. This method is ideal for a rapid response project since it is a low-cost monitoring system for crop failures. The next phase of my project is geospatial malnutrition predictions, which includes low crop yields, but is also dependent on another of other parameters. I have assembled a training data set for machine learning of malnutrition prevalence. Ordered by importance, these variables include the percent of females educated, distance to coasts, cereal yields, population, conflicts, and travel time to the nearest city. This method is able to predict malnutrition prevalence with minimal error. I fit a random forest regression to 15 years of training data with select boxes removed. Here, I show the malnutrition prevalence in 2015 with the boxes filled in with predictions. The correlation between the predicted and actual malnutrition was 0.89, with an average error of 5.4%. Real-time malnutrition estimates could be useful for forecasting famine severity and planning the production and distribution of specialized nutritious foods. It could also help identify factors that influence malnutrition for more targeted international development. Thank you for having me here today.